in this question, Mr. John's financial year ends on 31st March. So it means financial year starts on which date? 1st April. Financial year ends on 31st March. It means that financial year starts on 1st April. Okay? Yeah. Now see, on 1st April 2012, what he did? On 1st April 2012, he purchased furniture. He brought one asset, furniture. And the cost of furniture is $25,000. And paid by check. He brought the furniture costing $25,000 and he made the payment by check. Now see, after that, he decided to depreciate the furniture using the reducing balance method. Here, which method he is using? Reducing balance method, not the straight line method. Now see the next, after this, Mr. John sold the furniture to Mary for $3,100, and on which date? On 1st April 2014. He brought that furniture in which year? 2012? And in 2014, on 1st April, he sold that furniture to Mary. And at what price? $3,100. Now what is the question? Open necessary ledger accounts in the books of Mr. John. But before that, we need to do some working. We need to compute depreciation. So see here, year first, year second, year third, and year fourth. I am taking 4 years. And first I will compute the depreciation. And using which method? Reducing balance method. So see, let me consider some rate of depreciation. He decided to depreciate the furniture at the rate of 20% per annum. And which method? Using the reducing balance. So see, in the year first, what was the opening value? $25,000. Now on this 25,000, he will charge. Let me take the year. The first year is which one? 2012, 2013, isn't it? 2012, 2013. This is the first year. On 1st April, he brought the furniture, and on 31st March, the year will over. So, first year is which one? 2012-13. So, in this year, on 1st April, the value of the furniture was $25,000. Now, on this, he will charge the depreciation at the rate of 20%. So, see, the depreciation will be $5,000. Now, what will be the closing value? $25,000 minus $5,000. This is the closing value. And this closing value will be the opening value for the next year. Next year, which one? 2013 and 14. This is the next year. So this 20,000 will be the opening value. Agree? Now again, in this year, I will charge depreciation at the rate of 20%. But this 20% now I will apply on the opening value, not on the cost of the asset. So on the opening value. This time the opening value is $20,000. And on this 20,000 at the rate of 20%. So the depreciation will be this time 4,000. Now what will be the closing value? 20,000 minus 4,000. The closing value will be 16,000. Now this 16,000 will be the opening value in the next year. Next year is 2014-15. And in this year, on the first day we sold the furniture. And the opening value will be how much? 16,000. Agreed? In this year 2014-15, on 1st April 2014, I sold the furniture. Mr. John sold the furniture to Mary, isn't it? $4,3100. So that's why I am not computing depreciation for this year, okay? Because in this year, on the first date, we sold the furniture. Mr. John sold the furniture. So first we need to do this working, agree? Yeah. Now see the recording. We need to prepare open necessary ledger accounts in the books of Mr. John. So see, these are the necessary ledger accounts. First we will open furniture account, then provision for depreciation, then we have one more account that is known as furniture disposal account. So in this account we will record the sale of that furniture. Okay? Yeah. Now see, first I will pass the entry. I brought the furniture, isn't it? So what will be the entry? I bought the furniture for how much amount? Tell me. 25,000. And I paid by check $25,000, isn't it? So increase in asset, So furniture account will be debited with how much amount? $25,000. And I paid by check. It means bank balance will reduce. It means decrease in asset means credit. Agreed? One asset is increasing and another asset is decreasing. So this will be the entry. Understood or not? Increase in asset debit and decrease in asset credit. Now see in this entry. This entry I will pass on which date? On 1st April 2014, isn't it? So see, furniture account is debited in this entry. So in the furniture account on the debit side I will make the posting. Furniture account is debited. So in the furniture account on the debit side I will put the amount $25,000 and I will write the name of the opposite account, that is bank. Agreed? Yeah. I will write 25,000 and then I will write the name of the opposite account bank. And I will put the date 2014 and I brought this on April 1st. Understood the posting? Now see, when the year will over? The year will over on 31st March 2015. Isn't it? So on that day, I will record the depreciation. And how much depreciation? See, this is the depreciation for the first year, 5,000. So this is the depreciation we computed now. Now with this, with the amount of this, with this amount I will make, I will record the depreciation. And see what I will do. Depreciation is loss. So I will debit profit and loss account. Profit and loss account with the amount of depreciation. How much? 5,000. Okay? Yeah. Just a minute. With the amount of 5,000 I will pass the entry. And what I will do now, I will credit the provision for depreciation account, because with the amount of this 5,000 I need to reduce the furniture, isn't it? I need to decrease the asset, and decrease in asset means credit. But rather crediting the asset, I will credit the contra asset account, and the name of that contra asset is which one? Provision for depreciation. Provision for depreciation. Provision for depreciation. Agree? With over 5,000. Actually, this provision for depreciation account is representing the furniture account. Representing the furniture account up to the amount of depreciation. Understood? So this entry we will record. Getting my point? Now see, in this entry, provision account credited. This entry we passed on which date? On the last date of the year. So on provision account is created, isn't it? So in the provision account on the credit side, first I will put the last date 2015, March 31st, isn't it? March 31st is the last date. And provision account created, so on the credit side I will make the posting with 5,000 and I will write the name of the opposite account, profit and loss account. Agree? Yeah. So this is the posting, this is the recording of depreciation. Getting my point? So my first year is over. Now I will compute the balance of both the accounts. So first I am going to compute the balance of furniture account, 25,000. Same total year 25,000, the balance will come same. And I will write here, balance carried down. And I will put the date 2015, last date of the year, and March 31st. Understood? And this balance I will carry forward in the next year. Next year, which one? 2015, April 1st. April 1st. And I will carry forward this balance. Balance, just a minute. Balance brought, brought down. And how much amount? Same amount. Agreed? So, this is 25,000. There is no change in the value of the furniture account, same value. Furniture account is appearing at $25,000 with the same amount. But actually the value of furniture is reduced. But still in the furniture account we are saying furniture at what price? $25,000. And the amount of depreciation is we are accumulating in this provision account. Now see, so the way we computed the balance of this furniture account is in the same manner, now we will compute the balance of provision for depreciation account. So see, the total 5,000 same amount I will write here 5000, and now this account will show balance. How much? 5000. Balance carried down, and I will put the last date 2015 March 31st. And this is credit balance, isn't it? Now credit balance in the next year I will show on the credit side, 2015 April 1st beginning date, and I will show balance brought down and how much amount, same amount I have. So in this manner the first year is over. Now we are in the second year. In the second year on the first date, in the second year furniture account is showing this much balance on the first date, $25,000, and provision for depreciation account is showing $5,000 balance. How much? $5,000. Now again, when the second year will over, 2016, isn't it? Sorry. Just a minute, I passed the wrong year. Here will come 2012, and here will come 2013, and here will come 2013. Yeah, and here also I need to make the change. 2013. Here also 2013. First year. First year, second year now. Okay? Now it's okay? Yeah. Now see, when the next year, this year will over, 2014, March 31st. This is the beginning date, 2013 April 1st, and the year will over 2014 March 31st. So again I will charge depreciation, isn't it? So this time I will not pass entry for buying the asset, because you brought the asset in the first year. So in the second year only you record the depreciation. So this is the last date, and on and same entry I will pass, this entry. The same entry I will pass, profit and loss account debit, provision for depreciation credit. Okay, so provision for depreciation is credited. So on the credit side I will make the portion profit and loss account. I will write the name of the opposite account. Okay, and this, yeah, this time the amount of depreciation will be 4000. Okay, so we made the schedule, we made this table. So in the second year the amount of depreciation is 4000. Agreed? So with that 4000 I pass the end. Now again I will compute the balance. So again furniture account will show same balance, no change. Okay? Yeah, so same balance will come. But the date will change. This time the year will over 2014, March 31st. And same balance will come, 25. Agree? Now the next year will start 2014, April 1st. April 1st, and I will write the balance. I will draw down the balance, same amount. How much? $25,000. Okay? No change in the value of furniture account. Now see the balance in provision account. See the balance in provision account. See what will be the balance this time? 9000. Okay? So see 9000, and I will write the balance here. I will compute the balance, carry it down. How much amount? 9000. And I will put the last date. Last date will be 2014, and this date March 31st. Agreed? Yeah. Now next year I will carry down this balance. The next year will be 2014 April 1st. April 1st. And I will write down the balance. Balance brought down, and how much amount? Same amount, 9000. Okay. So in this manner the second year is over. Now we are in the third year. Now in this third year what we have done, we on the first day we sold the furniture. Today is the first day of the third year. Third year and on first day. And on this first day we sold out the furniture. And we sold out the furniture to whom? To Mary. Okay? Now see what entry we will pass. Now this year on the first day we sold out the furniture. So we will not record depreciation, because on the first day we sold out the furniture. In the third year we didn't use the furniture even a single day. Third year and on the first day we sold out the furniture, isn't it? So we will not record the amount of depreciation. We will immediately pass entry for the sale of the current share. Agree or not? Not 2015, 2014, April 1st, on the first day. Okay? See, this is our third year, 2014-15. This is our third year, and on its first date we sold the furniture. So we didn't use the furniture for a single day. So why we will record the depreciation? Immediately I will pass entry for the sale, isn't it? Yeah. Now see, can you tell me the book value of the furniture today? What is the book value? No, that is not the book value. See, 25,000 until now, how much we depreciated the furniture? 9,000. So the book value is 16,000. It means today the furniture, the actual value of the furniture is not 25,000. The actual value of the furniture is what? 16,000. Okay? So how I got this? First I will take furniture cost from here and till date. How much we depreciated the furniture? 9,000? Up to 9,000? So that we need to subtract. So 25 minus 9, we will get the actual value of the furniture. Agree? So this is the net book value of the furniture. This is what? Net book value. Understood or not? This will be termed as net book value. How much? 16,000. Agree? And at what price I sold the furniture? 3,100. Mr. John sold the furniture for 3,100. Isn't it? Sale value. What is the sale value of the furniture? Sale value. The sale value of the furniture is $3,100. So tell me, sale value is more or net book value? So there will be profit or loss? Loss, yes. How much loss? We sold for 3,100 and the book value of the furniture is 16,000. So there is a loss of 12,900. This is loss. So this will be termed as loss on sale of furniture. Understood the calculation? First I computed net book value. How I computed net book value? I took the cost of the furniture and I subtracted the depreciation till date. So I got net book value. Then I compared the net book value with the sale value. When sale value is less, then the net book value. How much? 12,900. And that is a loss. Agree? Now this after you know deciding this. Hello? Net book value is more than the sale value, therefore we got a loss. And how much loss? 12,900. Now after computing this, now see how I will record this to sale. Okay? This is what I need to do. So I will open a new account, one more account. And what is the name of that account? Yeah, furniture disposal account. And in this account, see what I will do. In this account, I will transfer this balance of this furniture account and the balance of this provision account. Agree? So I will transfer this. The day when you sell the asset, you transfer the value of the, you transfer the value whatever is there in the asset account, and you transfer the value, the concerning depreciation, the provision for depreciation value from the provision account. And to which account you will transfer this value? To this furniture disposal account. Now see the entry. Now see, I am transferring this furniture account, okay? Understood? Yeah, so see, furniture account showing debit balance or credit balance. So to transfer it, I will credit the furniture. I will credit the furniture account. And with how much amount? Is it here? Yeah, 25,000. With 25,000, I will credit the furniture account and I will debit which account? Furniture disposal account. Furniture disposal account. Understood? Now, see, the logic is what? The logic behind this entry is what? Furniture account is showing debit balance. So, to transfer it, credit there. Take the asset on the opposite side.
furniture showing debit balance, so credit the furniture account. Agree? This is the only simple rule. If furniture account showing debit balance, so to transfer it, what you will do? It is showing debit balance, so credit it. And which account you will debit? To which account you are transferring this furniture account? To furniture disposal. So that account will be debited. Now see, now this is the entry for transferring the asset. Now in this entry, furniture account credited. So on the credit side, I will make the posting. 2014 on April 1st, I transferred the furniture account on April 1st. And furniture account created, so on its credit side, I will write $25,000 and I will write the name of the opposite account. And the name of the opposite account is given furniture disposal account. Agree? Yeah, this is the name of the opposite account. Got it? Now what is the balance in furniture account now? Sorry, now there is no balance, zero balance. Because total of both the sides are equal. Understood? Here also 25,000, here also 25,000, so there is no balance. It means furniture account is closed. Why closed? Because I transferred this furniture account to which account? Furniture disposal account. So furniture account is closed. Now there is no more balance. Total of both the sides are equal. Agree? So I made posting in furniture account. So the next posting will be in which account? Furniture disposal account. So furniture disposal is debited. So on its debit side, I will write the amount and I will write the name of the opposite account, and the name of the opposite account is furniture account. Agree or not? And which date? April 1st, 2014. Agree? 2014, April 1st. And name of the opposite account? Furniture account. And amount how much? $25,000. Agree? Yeah, so I will transfer furniture account. Now I need to transfer this provision for depreciation account. So see how I will transfer. So see, provision for depreciation account showing which balance? Provision for depreciation account. Now I need to transfer this account, isn't it? Which balance? 9,000, so agree, but which balance? Debit or credit balance? Credit balance. So to transfer it, I will debit this account. It is showing credit balance, so debit this account. Provision for, understood the rule? If an account is showing debit balance, then credit it, and if an account is showing a credit balance, then debit it. Okay? Now provision showing which balance? Credit balance. So that's why I debit it. And I will transfer to this provision to which account? Furniture disposal account. Furniture disposal. And how much amount? Same 9,000. Agree? Now make the posting of this entry. Provision account debited. So on its debit side, 2014, I will make the posting on its debit side. April 1st. So debited, so on its debit side, I will write 9,000. And what is the name of the opposite account? Furniture disposal account. Okay? So this I will write. Understood or not? Yeah. So I made posting in provision account. Posting done in provision account. Now I need to make posting in furniture disposal account. So furniture disposal is debited or credited? So on its credit side, I will make the posting. 2014 April 1st. On its credit side, I will make the posting. How much amount? 9,000, isn't it? And I will write the name of the opposite account. Provision for depreciation. This is the name of the opposite account. Agree? Now see, this furniture disposal account is showing the, you know, net book value of the furniture. See, compute the difference, compute the balance of this furniture disposal. 25,000 minus 9,000, isn't it? So this will show, now this is what? Now 25,000 minus 9,000. So this is the net book value. Agree? And we sold furniture for how much price? $3,100. So of course there will be loss. And how much loss? 12,900. Now see the entry. see what entry I will pass. See, I got money, I sold the furniture now, and we assumed that I sold furniture to Mary on cash basis. Cash. We sold furniture and Mary gave money to the John, to Mr. John. Okay? So Mr. John got cash, isn't it? So increase in cash will be debit. How much amount? 3100, isn't it? Increase in cash, debit. Agree? And what happened? There is a loss. And loss is increasing or decreasing? So increase in loss, debit. Loss on sale of furniture. Okay? So loss will be there also debited. How much amount? 12,900, isn't it? Now, asset increase or decrease? We sold the furniture. So asset increase or decrease? Decrease. So decrease in asset credit. So now I will credit this furniture disposal account. Because furniture account is no more. Furniture account is closed. And who has, which account replaced the furniture disposal? Sorry, which account replaced the furniture account? Furniture disposal. Earlier we had a furniture account, but we transferred furniture now to furniture disposal account. So furniture account is no more. Now, so rather writing furniture account, which account I will write? Furniture disposal. Furniture disposal. And how much price? 16,000. Because in the furniture disposal, see 16,000 is there. Understood or not? See 25,000 minus 9,000, 16,000 is there. So this entry I will pass. Understood? We got money, increase in cash, debit. There is a loss, so increase in loss, debit. And decrease in asset, credit. So you are thinking that why I am not writing furniture? Because furniture account is transferred to which account? Furniture disposal is there now. Yeah, so rather writing furniture account, now I will consider which account? Furniture disposal. So asset is decreasing, so decrease in asset, credit. And what is the value of that asset today? 16,000. That is the value of furniture. I got only this much amount and there is a loss of 12,900. Okay? Now I need to post this entry. So we have furniture disposal account here, isn't it? Now in the entry, furniture disposal account is created. So on its credit side I will write. First I will write cash, name of the opening account 3100. Then I will write loss on sale of furniture. How much amount? 12,900. I am making posting not in the cash account. I am making posting in furniture disposal. It is credited now. So that's why on its credit side I will write the name of the opposite account. Cash 3100 and loss on sale of furniture 12,900. And on the same date. April 1st. Agree? Now see, there is no balance. Furniture disposal account is also closed. See, total of both the sides are equal. This side also and this side also. Now furniture disposal account is also closed. So understood the entire thing?